Hi, today a short update video on these small garbage containers. This was the first version I ever did, without a lid, without wheels. The next one up was based on an idea that I could carry some toothpicks, so that's why this container has this height. A nice little gadget. One disadvantage though was that the lid could fall open. Also, I didn't much like the design of this little hinge, so I came up with this new design. The difference is obvious, I think. I think this looks better. It has the same height, so the toothpicks will still fit. Only downside now still is that the lid will just fall open by gravity. So that's what this new update is all about. This is the latest revision. You can see the difference right at the back there. This one has a little bump. This older one doesn't. And the idea behind that is that there's a small magnet, and at the top there you can see a small washer which I glued into place, and now it shuts and it stays shut. The forces aren't terribly big, but big enough to keep the lid closed even when the thing is full. Okay, I printed a second one of these. And I wanted to show how to clean and assemble this. There's only a bit of stringing between the two hinges, so that comes off easily enough. The lid is equally as simple. And I found that it's important to clean behind these hinge pins and even cut away some extra material with the knife so that the lid can close fully once it's mounted. This chamber is printed as a full overhang, so it requires some cleanup. So the washer will be seated in there. And there's always the trick to cleaning parts is trying not to stab yourself. Alcohol is good for now. It's a small ball magnet. It's pretty powerful. It has a diameter of about 5.1. And that hole is dimensioned accordingly. In that hole there's a small ridge about here, all the way around. That keeps the ball in place once you push it beyond that. I still have some wheels. Wheels and axles. It's a matter of placing the pin right on the hole. And then while keeping the wheel in place, just push the pin inward as straight as you can. A bit more. As you can see, it's a bit too tight, and the remedy for that is sticking a screwdriver in between here and twisting it. It still has a slight bit of play, which is okay. Next one, same procedure. A bit too tight. And now for the big moment. Click. Like I said, there's a ridge in there that will keep that magnet from ever falling out. If I wanted to remove this magnet now, I'd have to destroy this container. There's no other way to get it out. This is a standard M3 washer, slightly under 7 millimeters, and it has a thickness of about 0.5 millimeter. The trick is just laying it flat in its chamber, making sure it fits. The fit is quite okay. It also seems to be flush with the surface. And now I'll fix that washer in place with some super glue. That is much too much, but I'll let that sit. Okay, I'll give that some time to harden. After that, I'll be back. The glue has dried. The washer is in there quite tightly. It won't fall out anymore. Now it's time to mount the lid. The fit is a bit tight. Click. That's all there is to it. Of course, the first couple of turns are very tight. There's a lot of friction. But that'll go away pretty soon. Then the magnet in there can do its work. And finally, the last thing I'd like to do is color this logo. To that end, I take some acrylic primer, color white in this case. I put a bit of that in this plastic cup and added a bit of water to dilute it. Then I put some of that into the syringe. You need a steady hand and a bit of time, and let gravity do the work. First, let's prime the syringe. Still a lot of air in there, which might be a problem. Okay, so most of the air is out of the syringe now. And now I'll start filling area by area. A bit of overflow is not really a problem. I'll deal with that later. I said a bit of overflow. This is a bit much. Problem was the plunger of this syringe was a bit sticky, so I overshot. Let's try that again. I cleaned it off with a wet paper towel. Hopefully I'll have better luck this time. The trick is to use surface tension of the fluid. That's slightly better. Okay, I'll leave that to dry. The last thing to do is clean up the overshoots, and I'll show that on this earlier print. I did this one a couple of days ago, and as you can see, there's a bit of overshoot right here, in this part here, and around this area as well. The trick is quite simple. Take a small screwdriver with a very sharp tip and simply run it across the edge of that area. And your screwdriver will act like a small knife and cut away all the paint that's on the surface. And after I'm done, this is what it looks like. This one was slightly better. I'm pretty pleased. So that concludes my magnetic lid. I hope you liked it. If you did, you can find a link in the description below this video where you can find the files. For now, thanks for watching. Until next time.